Subscribe to our YouTube channel Pakistan Media Today and press the bell icon to get latest updates.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Guys, you won't believe what, you know, I just recorded 15 minutes tutorial, and when I just stopped recording, what I got to know is that microphone was off. That's freaking and a headache. How could I have forgotten this? I'm actually just laughing on myself. Okay, no problem. Well, so just let's get into the tutorial what we are just going to show you today. Today I'm actually testing out a microphone that is called Boya BYM1. Boya is the name of the company of the microphone, and BYM1 is the model, and you can buy it in on Amazon, I believe, in $20 or $20 to $21, I guess. I don't know the exact amount. You can go and search there. And as I'm living in Pakistan, so in Pakistan you can buy it in around 2,000 rupees. Rupees 2,000 PKR. Okay, and I have bought it in around like 1900 and something, and I bought it from a company directly. I went to their office, so that's why it did not cause me any shipping costs. And now I'm just recording it right from the microphone. Let's just double check. Let me pause this rendering. Let's just double check if it's recording. Yeah, it's recording it right now. It's the direct voice that you can listen from the microphone right away. And just minimize it. All right, and now this is a hardware and of my system, from which I can modify some changes, and I can apply some effects within the live recording, I guess. So I'm just gonna turn out the noise suppression, like how much noise is it gaining when it's recording directly from the microphone, that you can hear right away. And when I will turn it on, then it will cancel this noise. So this is how you will have an idea that how much voice does it record and how much noise does it record. And as well as one more thing that is gonna affect in noise suppression effect, is that it's gonna turn down the volume a bit. So I guess that's because it's going to turn down the noise, so it will have to turn down your volume as well. So just try it out. All right, now you can hear me, I believe, in noise suppression effect. And in this effect, it's, I believe, not going to record any kind of noise behind me and within this microphone. And now I'm just going to click on this effect as well, so that you can hear, you can listen what difference is going to be made by this effect. So I'm gonna apply this effect, and what it does is that it's gonna cancel the echo behind you. If you're in a larger room, and then there are a lot of persons that are speaking behind you. I'm sorry, I'm just describing it in a wrong way. Let me describe it again. So if you are in a large room and your voice is just striking the walls and and coming back, and it's just causing an echo sound and static sound. Yeah, now I got the correct word to elaborate it. If you're getting any type of static sound, voice is coming again and again, making some echo, so it's gonna cancel it out. So just I guess it's not causing any echo now as well. but let's just try what effect it's gonna make. All right, so now you can hear me in this effect in acoustic echo cancellation, and this is how it works. So I'm actually sitting in a small room. It's not that much larger that you would have an idea exactly about the echo cancellation, but I guess you might get the idea a little bit. And now the third effect we have is beam forming. What is beam forming? It's I'm not sure exactly about this because I don't have any manual for the software or anything, any tutorial I haven't watched. I just tried these synth and I tried to understand what are these effects like doing with our voice. So here, as I'm just going to turn it on, beam forming, directional recording. So by this word directional recording, what I'm trying to understand is that it might work like an omnidirectional microphone. Like you know, there are some types in microphone. When you will buy a professional microphone, like a condenser microphone or a dynamic microphone, so there you will get to know that there are some different types of the microphones. Some are of omnidirectional and some are like a cardioid mic. So cardioid mic, what effect or what kind of recording it sound is that, like it records some surrounding area as well, but mostly it's going to get your voice first, and then it will also like record the surrounding area like this. You can watch in this image, it's gonna focus on this part where your microphone is going to be located, and it will also record some voices from here and from here as well. But if we talk about the omnidirectional microphone, then it's going to record just from the direction that a person is speaking from, and I'm sorry, the direction of the microphone is placed and facing the direction. So this is it. It's going to record now. And by the way, let me tell you, I'm just recording it right in front of my mouth, and it's just placed with the around 1 to 2 inches distance, and I'm just recording it with the same volume of my voice that I actually speak normally in. I'm not raising my voice, I'm not like making any, giving any energy in that. I'm just speaking as I speak normally, just to let you guys know that how does it sound. And you can see here in the audio bars that it's not going like much higher than the mid frequency. So this is it. And what I got to know, these are my final words for this microphone, that if you're going to do some live sessions and you're not like a loud speaker, you don't speak loudly, if you don't speak loudly, or your voice is not that much energetic as my voice, so I'm also not energetic. So for the live sessions, this and in live sessions, you know, you want to, I guess you want to turn out this noise suppression effect as well, so that your audience won't listen any kind of noise, any kind of echo, any like surrounding voices. So you may want to turn all these on, because the reason I just told you. And but what will happen, it will not it will just not record the loud voice from you. So it will just record the voice that I'm recording in, and your live subscribers and viewers will not like this. So this is it. But if you are the one who can speak loudly, then you might want to go with this microphone. Otherwise, you can use this in live sessions without noise suppression. As this, I'm just going to turn it off once again. All the effects I'm just going to turn off. I've just turned off. And now you can hear me if it caused any kind of volume reduction or the raise of the volume. So if it increased, then it's good. If it still did not increase, then it's actually not good for the live sessions. However, if you want to use it for the recordings, manual recordings, then after recordings in post productions in Premiere Pro as well as in other audio softwares like Gold Wave and Audio Audition, Adobe Audio Audition, you can apply some effects on that, and those effects will increase the volume, and that might going to work for you. But again, for the live sessions, I would say no for this mic. That's it. Thank you so much. And yep, this is the end. Now I would like to let you know that I'm just going to make a lot of tutorials. I've planned a lot of things for my channels, and so that's why you should consider subscribing it. Just subscribe it off from there. I just told you where, and what you need to do is that press the bell icon. Thank you. Have a good day.